We have all whatever you are doing, give yourself a big fat imagine one great wave of love, one great wave of joy, a great wave of spiritual clarity. Imagine it all up your thighs like a big sticky mess of love. Imagine your soul is like a bazooka. Boom! Or a balloon that a little innocent child sets free to the heavens. And the camera pans up as that balloon floats free and a swell of music plays as it soars to the heavens. Then it comes down in the ocean and a turtle eats it. And it has internal hemorrhage and dies. You have killed that turtle. That's the wrong message you're sending. Don't set things free that are going to kill other things. You are attacking the world in the wrong way. Yes, you are. That's not the way to live. That is not the message to send. Like a python that's too big for your house. And you set it loose in a schoolyard with children. That python's gonna wrap itself around kids, and now you have caused a mess. That is not how we do it here, Cheryl. That is not going to heaven as a human. You can only go to heaven as a damn angel. You hear me? And that's why heaven is full of angels and not living, breathing people. Because people need oxygen, and there ain't no oxygen up there. It's a bit like one of those self-pleasuring choking games where you make a love with somebody and put your hands around their neck. They have life, but then you choke the life out of them while you're pleasuring them.
Oh, Dr. Ray, I like those.
Most women love that.
I love it.
You get on top of a woman, you crush her sternum, you crush her rib cage,
yes.
You put your hands around her neck, and you're giving it to her and taking it away. You're giving life, and you're taking life away at the same time. There's two things going on here, the hot and the cold. You know, you're choking, but you're giving life and feeling. Squeezing the love into them, but squeezing that life out. It's an in and an out motion going on here. You have just played the choking game. That's health. That's integration. That's what we are here to do every morning. Before we get started, we always that's a chakra attack. Hey, Cheryl.
Yes, Dr. A.
What'd I just say? What'd I just say one more time? What'd I just say?
What'd
I just say? You out there, what'd I just say? What did I just say? I said bang, bang, bang. No. That ain't the sound of me banging you.
Okay.
That's the sound of me attacking your chakra. We bring on Western street knowledge and Eastern spirituality together in a unified approach to contemporary integration. Such that the mind and body are one. Such that the ignorance and knowledge be one. Such that the sense and the nonsense be one. When you put sense and nonsense together, what the hell do you got? You got some bullshit going on in your mind. That's everything mushed together like a goddamn jambalaya. Peanut butter and ice cream, guns and butter, ants in your damn pen. It all makes sense, because you eat peanut butter and ice cream, you're going to get diarrhea, and you're going to have ants in your pants.
Are they eating the butter?
They're eating the shit. What do you think they're eating? Ants eat your shit, because you don't eat that peanut butter and that damn ice cream.
But do the ants crawl in your butthole?
No, they just eat the shit that's coming out your ass. When things don't agree with you, that's what I'm talking about. Now that's sense, and that's nonsense together, and they do not agree with each other, and now they have merged and gave your ass diarrhea. We're cleansing everything, mind, body, and your spirit. We're going big. We're going all the way. Nirvana, Buddha, Valhalla, everything in it. Not just a silly arrow that tells you which way to go north, but also a lot of other arrows that tell you other shit, like which way to the liquor store, or if some fool is getting fresh, or if you are at one with all mankind. A karma compass that tells you street shit and real shit, but also lots of other arrows, a whole bunch of arrows in that damn compass.
No, that's just, isn't that a GPS?
No. You're thinking about navigation, that kind of shit in your car.
Yeah, the liquor store.
You're wrong. You're in the car. You're navigating on foot. You understand?
Ah.
Now, I don't know what app you got, but your mind is an app. Cheryl, says she's fooling right now. This is a karma compass, everybody.
Okay.
That tells you street shit and real shit. It's like one of them sensors that tell you if there are aliens crawling in the ceiling and they are getting closer and you freaking the hell out because you are like, this alien gonna drop through the ceiling down and whoop some ass. Right, Cheryl? That damn alien gonna come through that ceiling and whoop some human ass. While the man is fighting the aliens, the women are in the corner crying.
That's not really fair, but...
It's not fair. But that's what happens in the movies. That's exactly what happened. You hide in the corner, or when you try to run, and you trip. Right? Not black women, but white women do trip. I'm sorry. I had to go there with you, but I gotta go there. I had to pull a race car out.
Comes
that's
in.
What happens. You sit in that goddamn corner, and you start to scream and cry. And while the aliens are killing your man, you're sitting there crying. Then they take you up to space, and they impregnate you. You understand what's gonna happen to you? They're gonna take you up there, and they're gonna do it to you. They're gonna do it to you good. They're gonna do it to you with their alien bomb. You understand? That's how they do it.
Oh,
and that's
no.
Why you got to get the spirituality in your body right now. Come on now. Today, it's all about empowering the ladies. Spiritual things come in threes. A three-part. Only not sleaze and no crossing swords and no worrying about what's right or wrong or if you enjoyed it too damn much because you're supposed to enjoy every last bit of it, Cheryl.
Yes.
Do you enjoy every last bit of it?
I enjoy most of it, yeah. I don't know about the aliens taking me to bed.
No. You don't know if you're going to enjoy that because it hasn't happened yet. You have no idea what that alien got in his alien pants. You understand? No one knows what kind of slong an alien has. You don't know that, Cheryl, so don't speak on it before you know
okay. What
the hell you're doing. Because you're supposed to enjoy it all. Every last bit of it. All life should be enjoyed. Right, Cheryl?
Mm-hmm.
You enjoy life, right?
Yeah, I love my life.
You go to those music festivals and take Molly and listen to some old-ass has-beens play a 25-minute version of a song. 25 damn minutes of the same damn bullshit you done heard before. Patchouli and nitrous, am I right?
I love camping.
By donating your car to an unspecified ambiguous charity. It's
on children who go blind from mercury exposure, while you get a healthy tax write-off. We rip off charities, while you rip off Uncle Sam by mass.